Hello, Brunswick High School. Thanks for watching BHS TV. Today is Monday, January 13th. I'm Nora Fillinger.
And I'm Kyla McElroy, and here's what's going on at BHS. This week's student handbook topic is electronic devices and cell phones. Students are permitted to have a cell phone in school, but its use is limited to before the start of first period, during lunch in the cafeteria, and after school. Students may also be allowed to use their phone in the classroom when instructed to do so by a teacher. They are not acceptable in the hallways. Any other use of a cell phone during school hours will result in disciplinary action. At no time can a student's cell phone be used to invade the privacy of another student. Let's communicate with others during passing periods and keep all phones and earbuds out of sight and out of mind. Let's go Bulldogs, be responsible, and do the right thing.
Anyone interested in being MVP on the BHS Science Super Bowl team, Mr. Jones is hosting a call-out meeting after school on Tuesday, January 21st. This year, the theme is the Roaring Twenties. Just come by at A2310 on the 21st or see Mr. Jones if you have any questions.
In an attempt to get students home quicker and allow our bus drivers to get to their second route, after-school buses will be released to leave the parking lot at 2:58 p.m. A one-minute warning horn will sound at 2:57 p.m. Students who miss their bus will be responsible for finding their own transportation. Please be responsible and be on time.
Senior shirts have arrived and are now available to pick up in the new DECA store. If you ordered a crew neck, please stop by C1304 near the cafeteria during 4th or 5th period to pick up yours soon.
If you are interested in attending the Leaders of Tomorrow Club, they meet on Thursdays after school in Mrs. L's room. They have key events coming up in February, including their Leadership Summit at Fishers High School, as well as their Black History Month event. Contact Mrs. L or Peyton Drain if you have any questions.
Are you a fan of the Roaring Twenties? Do you know your Gershwin from your Duke Ellington? Or are you interested in knowing more about the Chrysler Building and the Ringley Building? If so, come to the call-out meeting for the Academic Super Bowl Fine Arts team. This year, they will be looking at artists, musicians, and theaters from the 1920s. The meeting will be on Thursday, January 16th in A2307 at 3 p.m. They hope to see you there.
The Anime Club will be meeting on both Tuesday, January 14th and Tuesday, January 21st to make up for some missed time over winter break. Following the 21st, they will return to their normal second and fourth Tuesday of each month. See Ms. Cole with any questions.
Any sophomore or junior that is interested in learning more about Area 31 should sign up for the informational meeting at BHS on Thursday, January 16th. Area 31 staff will provide an overview of their programs and will be available to answer questions at that time. You must sign up for your team office by January 14th if you'd like to attend the meeting.
Anyone interested in learning the ins and outs of the new auditorium or that is interested in performing on stage in the spring play is encouraged to go to the first drama club meeting of the semester. It will take place after school until 4 p.m. today, Monday, January 13th, in the auditorium. You can go see everything the new space has to offer. The entrance is just across from the gathering stairs by the cafeteria.
We came back from winter break with the majority of BHS renovations completed. BHS TV's Arabella Brown wanted to find out what people think about the new additions.
With the new construction being opened up, we wanted to hear how the BHS staff and students felt about the new layout.
I would say that the construction was worth the wait because of all the new things that are offered to all the underclassmen. The theater allows for a band, orchestra, and choir to actually have a performance space rather than having to haul over all their stuff to middle schools and perform there. The weightlifting is amazing in regards to, you know, any of our athletes. It's way better than just the small little room they had before. So a lot of the new upgrades, while it took a while, are definitely worth it for a lot of the underclassmen. I just wish I get to use them more.
I do see the school as a better place because it just overall looks nicer and easier to get around, and they spent a lot of time doing it, and they did a good job.
No, it is not hard to adjust to the new layout of the school.
The first day it was kind of confusing, just like to get used to it, but after that I knew my way around because it's not like that much that reopened.
To think about this, I have only been in theater for about a year now, and for me to have had to perform in the black box and then rehearse for the musical in the hallways, to actually have a theater is 10 times better than anything we had before. So I'm certainly excited to perform in the new theater.
It's great to hear that everyone is enjoying our new school. Arabella Brown, BHS TV.
Thanks, Arabella. The school really does look amazing.
Now it's time for sports. Hey, Jordan, what do you have for us today?
Hey, guys. It was a very busy and fun weekend for BHS Athletics with lots going on. Let's get things started with the basketball teams who are in the Hendricks County Tournament. The night started with the boys taking on Plainfield. It was a close game the entire way, and the Dogs trailed the Quakers after each of the first three quarters. But the fourth quarter was all Brownsburg, and the Dogs earned a 55-43 victory and their 23rd county title. Pierce Thomas led the way with 14 points, followed by Connor Lucas with 13 and Luke Lacey with 10. Jacoby McGowan, Tyree Lackey, and Quentin Bragg all played key roles in the victory as well. Nice job, guys.
It feels good. You know, they were fired up coming in, they talking on the media that they got the best team, but we really showed out. We got the best team, and I'm just really proud of the guys, the way we fought all game.
It's just great to know that our team can come back like that. You know, we were down a little bit the first half, and I think we're all just really good at fighting, playing through the ups and downs, so it feels amazing.
A little later, the ladies also took on Plainfield. Despite playing a close game with the Quakers earlier this season, it was all Dogs the second time around, with BHS earning a 55-32 win. Allison Bussey had 15 points and 5 rebounds to lead the Dogs, while Mackenzie Steen added 10 points and 6 assists. Allie Becky had 6 points and 10 rebounds. The Dogs led by just 4 at the half, but played excellent defense in the second to secure the victory. Nice job, ladies. Make sure to check BHS TV's social media for extended highlights of both games.
Feels really good. We're really excited to play tonight, and we just came out with a lot of energy and we're ready to go. And I think it's a good win for us going into tournament time soon.
Feels really good because we worked so hard to get here, and it just shows all of our dedication from the season.
The swimming and diving teams traveled to Hamilton Southeastern for the HCC Invitational over the weekend. The girls came home with a third place finish in the loaded conference. Leading the way for the Dogs were Margie Miller with fifth place finishes in the 50 and 100 free, Annika Schakel in six in the 100 fly, Elise Dahlke in six in the 100 free, and all three relay teams with top five finishes. Nice job, ladies. The guys finished fourth overall and were led by Austin Kerr, who is your HCC champion in both the 50 and 100 freestyle. Other top finishers for the Dogs included Jacob Johnson with 6th place finishes in both the 200 IM and 500 free, Nate Schakel in 6th in the 100 fly and 3rd in the 100 breast, and a nice showing by all three relay teams as well. Both teams will host Plainfield next week. Congrats to the Lady Bulldogs bowling team, who are sectional champions for the 7th straight year, and the boys, who finished 2nd. Both teams will advance to regionals in Noblesville. Alex Paddock, Emily Burleson, Megan Kennedy, Aaron Cardinal, Allison Whitmire, Rashawn Miles, and James Levisic all advanced in singles competition as well. Nice job. That's it for sports today. Back over to you guys.
Thanks, Jordan. That's all I've got for your day, BHS. Thanks for watching.
Have a great day, and we'll see you on Wednesday.